Hello students, welcome to Machine Design 1 classes. We are in basics of mechanism in the first module. In the previous videos we have seen inversions of four bar chain mechanisms, inversions of single threaded crank chain mechanism, inversions of double threaded crank chain mechanism. Okay, nearly we have completed 3/4 of the module, that is 75% of the first module we have completed. We are going to see intermittent motion mechanisms and few other quick return mechanisms and straight line mechanisms in this video. Okay, let us go to the class. First topic, intermittent motion mechanism. Intermittent motion mechanism means the motion will not be continuous, it will have some intervals. Okay, often it will have some intervals. For example, take this case. In this mechanism, when the red color wheel rotates one revolution, the blue color wheel will rotate 1/4 of the revolution. Okay, so this is a intermittent motion mechanism. Similarly, here also this is Geneva wheel mechanism. Okay, this is Geneva wheel mechanism. When the green color wheel rotates one full revolution, this red color, this portion will rotate 1/4 1/5 of the motion. Okay, these are all intermittent motion mechanism. And here ratchet ball, in ratchet ball also it can move in only one direction. For example, here it can move in the anti-clockwise direction only. If it try to rotate in the clockwise direction, this ball will stop the motion of ratchet wheel. So this is also a kind of intermittent motions, because it can have motion in only one direction. If it try to move in another direction, means it will be stopped. Okay, we will see some more mechanisms and how it is working. Intermittent motion mechanism transforms an incoming motion, generally uniform rotational, in an outgoing progressive of alternative intermittent motion. Okay, progressive motion will be there, or alternative intermittent motion will be there. Okay, what? Progressive means in this case and in this case the motion is progressive. Okay, what? It will be continuous but will have small breaks. Okay, what? But in this case it is having alternative motion. If it try to rotate in alternative direction, means it will be stopped. Both the things are called intermittent motion mechanism. Usually the intermittent motion is rotational, but it can be also transformed into translator or rectilinear motion by means of appropriate transmission mechanism. Most of the time it will be like rotary motion only. Okay, but sometime it will be converted into translator or rectilinear motion by means of some other extra components. First let us see about ratchet wheel, ratchet ball mechanism. This ratchet ball, you might have seen this in wells. While lifting water from the well, they might use this kind of ratchet ball. Okay, what? When they have the ball, when it rotate in the counterclockwise direction, when they lift, the ratchet will rotate. If they accidentally left the rope, means the ratchet should rotate in clockwise direction, but it will not rotate in clockwise direction. Ball will stop the motion of ratchet. Okay, wow. So this is ratchet ball mechanism. And when the ratchet wheel rotates, the ball will oscillate in up and down direction. Like when the ratchet wheel rotates, this ball will move up and down. Okay, because of the teeth, when the tip of ball travel on the teeth, the teeth will lift ball up and down. Okay, so up and down motion means kind of reciprocating motion. So here small condition is there. The line of action PN. So this line of action PN, okay, line of action PN of the driving pole and tooth must pass between centers O and A in order to have pole remaining in contact with the teeth. So this line of action PN is the line of action. So when the pole contact with the teeth, it will have a kind of action. Okay, va? So that is line of action. Okay, kind of friction force will be there. When the pole travel on the ratchet wheel, it will have a kind of friction force between pole and ratchet wheel. Okay, va? So for that frictional force, if we draw line of action, means that particular line of action should travel in the axis of OE. It should travel in the axis OE. Okay, then only it will have equilibrium motion. So ratchet wheel means a suitably shaped teeth, that is called as ratchet wheel. Okay, based on the wheel that has teeth cut out of it and a pole that follows as the wheel turns. So when the wheel turns, the teeth will lift the pole up and down. So I told you, no, while lifting water from the well, even in olden days they have used this mechanism, ratchet pole mechanism. Some other topics: quick return motion mechanism, straight line mechanism, intermittent motion mechanism, toggle mechanism, pantograph, anchorman steering gear mechanisms. These also we are going to see in this video. I'll give a small glimpse. When you read the book, you can see the working principle. Okay, well, I'll show you some animations. By seeing the animation itself, you can understand how it is working. But in the book, if you read, means they will give elaborately, they have given about these mechanisms. Use S.S. Rutten book or R.S. Kurmi book. Okay. So in the previous video itself, we have seen Whitworth quick return mechanism and Kranken slotted lever quick return mechanism. So now we are going to see only dragging mechanism. Dragging mechanism. When you see the dragging mechanism, it looks like a 4-bar chain mechanism. Okay, va? Already you know that quick return mechanism means in the forward stroke, it will remove the material. In the forward stroke, the stroke will be slower than the return stroke. Return stroke will be quicker than the forward stroke, because in the forward in the return stroke, the cutting tool will not remove any material. So we don't want to waste the time. So the return stroke should be quicker, but in the forward stroke, it will remove the material. So it has to remove properly and smoothly, and both the cutting tool and the object on which we are performing operation, both the things should not get damaged because of the cutting process. Okay, well, so only the forward motion or the cutting stroke should be slower than the return stroke. Okay, let us see the dragging mechanism. This is also the inversion of 4-bar chain mechanism with the 4 turning pairs. How it is inversion of 4-bar chain mechanism, I will explain. Watch carefully. This is a fixer link. This is also a fixer link. So they have connected the fixer link like this. So this is fixer link. Let us consider this as link 1. Okay. So this is link 2. This is link 3. Link 2. Link 3. This is link 4. Okay. It has 4 links. That's why we call this as a 4 bar mechanism. But in addition to this, they have attached an extra link. Link 5. That is connected with the piston. That link 5 is connected with the piston. So it is also a simple 4 bar chain mechanism, but they have used a lever, fifth one. It is a lever, okay? They have used extra lever, and that lever is connected with the piston, and that piston is sliding on the fixed surface in the front and back direction, that is rectilinear motion. So they will have a kind of ram along with this piston. There will be a kind of ram, okay? When the piston moves, the ram will be like this, okay? When the piston moves, the ram will move along with the piston, because the ram will be fixed on the piston, and on the ram they will have the cutting tool. So this is cutting tool, okay? This is a cutting tool. On the ram, on the edge of the ram, they will have cutting tool. So when the crank rotates in this direction, this portion, this is a lever, this portion will also rotate, okay? So this small circle is a path, tracing path by point B. That is, this small circle is a rotating path of AB crank, okay? This big circle, it is the rotating path of CD, okay? This is the rotating path of CD. So here we can't say this link as a lever. If something is rotating, means that is called as crank. So here number 2 is also crank, number 4 also crank, okay? Link number 2 and link number 4, both of them were cranks only. Link number 3 is a connecting rod. Link 5 is also a kind of connecting rod. So it is link 5 is connecting this 4 bar chain mechanism with the ram or piston. So this is how this mechanism is working. Okay. So here also forward stroke is larger than the forward stroke is larger than the return stroke. Next topic, straight line mechanisms. Do you remember elliptical trammel? Elliptical trammel is a device used to trace ellipse. Okay, that's a device or that's a mechanism used to trace ellipse. Similarly, straight line mechanism is a mechanism or a device used to draw perfectly straight lines. Okay. There are two kinds of straight line mechanisms available. Okay, accurate straight line mechanism, and one more thing is, in normal case, we can get straight line, but it won't be accurately straight. Okay. Further, in one case, only turning pairs will be used. In another case, one sliding pair will be used. Okay, in one case, only turning pairs, there won't be any sliding pair. But in another one case, turning pairs will also be there and sliding pair will also be there. Okay, I told you, no, approximate straight line mechanism, exact straight line mechanism, approximate straight line motion mechanism, exact straight line motion mechanism. First one, Beachlier mechanism. Diagram itself, you can see. See the point P. When the link BD, when the link BD oscillates, this P, point P, will trace a perfect straight line like this. If you attach a pencil or sketch under the point P, you can get a straight line like this. That's why it is called as straight line mechanism. Okay. How many links are there in this mechanism? A and B are fixed links. A and B are fixed links. Chariya? AE, so fixed link number one. So this is link one, and fixed link is a link one. AE is a link two. AE is a link 2, then EC link 3, ED link 4, PD link 5, this is link 6, link 7, link 8. So totally 8 links are there, okay? Totally 8 links are there, and all of them are having only turning pairs. There is no sliding pair. Okay, wow. So this is a turning pair. 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 This is also a turning pair. Turning pair means link 2. Link 2 is turning with respect to link 1. This is also a turning pair. That means link 8. This particular link is link 8 is turning or oscillating with respect to link 1. Okay, that's why we are telling this is turning pair. Similarly, what else we can see? Link 7. Take link 7. Okay, link 7 is turning or oscillating. Both are same. Turning means it doesn't mean that it has to rotate fully. Okay, wow. It can oscillate. That also considered as a turning only. Okay. So link 7. Link 7 is oscillating or turning with respect to link 1. With respect to B. B is a link 1. Okay. This is how all the pairs are turning pairs. Okay. And these are some calculations. How we have to design the Beachlier straight line mechanism. What should be the angle between OAP? It should be a should be OAP should be a perpendicular. Okay, wow. So this is how we have to design it. So that particular link, it should be perpendicular to this line. Okay, wow. Here also it should be perpendicular. Then only we can get this straight line. Then only we can get this. Here we have a straight line, no? Then only we can get the straight line. These derivations you can see in your book. Okay. See, this is how this mechanism is working. Beachlier straight line mechanism. See, this red color thing. This dotted lines. Okay. Straight line. Exact straight lines. Okay. So they have mentioned, no, here also perpendicular. Okay, wow. If you draw a locus line, you draw a line like this means it will be perpendicular. Okay, so this is what they have mentioned in the previous slide. Previous slide, we can see here, no? This perpendicular line. If it is perpendicular here means, okay, if it is perpendicular here means, we will get the straight line here. Okay, so when we design it, it should be, we have to be very careful. Here it should be perpendicular. BD is the locus. Okay, so this AB should be perpendicular to BD. If it is perpendicular means we can get this mechanism, beach layer straight line mechanism. Beach layer exact straight line motion mechanism. Next, pantograph. Pantograph, from this image itself, from this animation itself, we can understand. Pantograph is used to draw smaller images from the larger images. Okay. In the olden days, to draw maps, they have used pantograph. In the olden days, to draw maps, they have used this pantograph mechanisms. Similar to beach layer straight line mechanism, here also we have certain derivations. Okay, this is for the OC by OD ratio. OC by OD ratio means this ratio, the ratio between this line and this line, or link OC and link OD. The ratio between these two links are called as magnification factor. Okay, the ratio between these links, two links, are called as magnification factor. For example, if the ratio between OC and OD is 3 means the image drawn at this end will be 3 times larger than this end. Okay, well, suppose if it is 2, the ratio is 2 means the image drawn at this end will be 2 times larger than the image drawn at this end. Okay. So the junction A, here a pencil or sketch will be attached. The junction E, here also a pencil or sketch will be attached. If you draw some image on this end, will be, N means the same image will be replicated at this end in a smaller size. Otherwise, if you draw some small image at this end, means the same image will be replicated in the larger size at this end. Next, double lever mechanism or Watt's straight line mechanism. This is also a kind of four bar chain mechanism, inversion of four bar chain mechanism, because this is link 1, this is also link 1, link 2, link 3, link 4. So one is fixed link, okay, one is a fixed link, one is fixed link. Even if you have 100 fixed links, that will be considered as only one link. Okay, so one is a fixed link, then 2, 3, 4, 2 and 4 are lever, not cranks. 2 and 4 are levers. If you have 2 levers means it will have the motion. If you trace the motion means you will get the motion like this.
Okay, if you trace the motion means you will get the motion like this. Okay. It's like a loop, a small loop like this. Like this, we will get the image, the trace point. If we trace it, means we will get the curve like this. Okay. So this is a straight line. Okay, from this place. To this place is a straight line. Okay, exact straight line. That's why they call this is a kind of straight line mechanism. Okay. Next, few more straight line mechanism. This is also a kind of four bar chain mechanism. Okay. Here, how many links are there? This is fixed link. This and this are fixed links. Okay, they have put for number 4 for this. Okay, chair. Okay, you will also put number 4 for the chair, right? Number 4 is a fixed link, and this is a lever. This is also lever, and 2 is a connecting rod. See, number 2 is a ternary link. This blue color line. This all the three blue lines are one link. Okay, this all three lines together one link. It will be like a plate like this. It will be like a plate like this. This is a ternary link. So how many links are there in this mechanism? It is also having 4 links. Okay, so here also it is tracing the straight line from this point to this point. It is tracing a straight line. Okay, Roberts mechanism. Next, toggle mechanism. Up to this, we have seen exact straight line mechanism. Now, toggle mechanism. Okay, in toggle mechanism also, we can trace a straight line at point B. Using point B, we can trace a straight line, but it will not be a exact straight line. Okay, it will be like a cross line or slanting line. Okay, so it's an approximate straight line mechanism. In the fourth slide, I have shown a statement. Okay, if a straight line mechanism has only turning pairs or rotating pairs, means that is called as exact straight line mechanism. Okay, if a straight line mechanism is having some sliding pair, here we have a sliding pair, this is a sliding pair. If it is having a sliding pair, means then that cannot be a exact straight line mechanism, that could be a approximate straight lines. Okay, so where this toggle mechanism is used? This toggle mechanism is used in punching machines. Okay, in punching machines they are using this toggle mechanism. In what way they can use this toggle mechanism, how it can be used in punching machine? See, OA rotates. Okay, when OA rotates, link AB is a connecting rod. So when OA rotates, BI, this will oscillate like this. Okay, it will try to bring the piston in the forward and the backward direction. This is how this mechanism is working. OA, AB, OB, BC, C is a piston. Okay. How it is used as a punching machine? In two ways it can be used as a punching machine. Here they will have a punch. Okay. Here workpiece will be there. here workpiece will be there. Okay, when it rotate in the downward direction, it will punch and then will go back. Okay, it will punch and then will go back. This is how it will work. Otherwise, here we can have a punch. Okay, here we can have a punch. When the piston move in the forward direction, it will punch. When the piston move in the return direction, it will not punch. It will come out freely. Okay. Here also this angle is very important. Okay. Based on the angle only, we can define the force on the piston. Okay. If the angle is around 30 to 60, if the angle is around 30 to 60 means we can give more force. If the angle reduced more than that means the force given will be reduced. So this is the animation. This is how it is working.